Everyone, and a warm welcome to Birmingham for the opening ceremony of the IBSA World Games for 2023. What an evening we have in store as we kick off a fortnight of competitive action across a range of wonderful sports. A staggering 60 nations from across the globe have descended on the Midlands, and here are some of them now, from Japan to Puerto Rico and Finland as well. And I can tell you, the Aussies are here in their droves as well. All I've witnessed throughout today and heard so far is joy and laughter, so much unity and team spirit as well. And of course, some of the athletes have already been in action in the partially sighted and blind football. Representatives there from Ukraine and Spain arriving at our special venue for the evening as well. Birmingham so proud to be hosting such an occasion. The excitement is palpable at Symphony Hall as well, which is our venue for tonight for this spectacular event. It's awash with colour. And of course, the games began back in 1998 in Madrid in Spain. The IBSA World Games have become the world's biggest sport event for athletes with visual impairments, with various names over the years, including the World Blind Sports Championships and IBSA World Championships and Games. The multi-sport competition is headed up every 4 years and a chance for new and established athletes to compete against a strong field of their peers in both Paralympic and non-Paralympic sports. Many athletes who competed have gone on to win medals at the Paralympic Games or reach the highest heights of success everywhere else. It really is the pinnacle of the international calendar outside of the Paralympic Games, and in some cases gives athletes the opportunity to qualify for the Paralympic Games as well. Over 2 million people in the UK are living with sight loss, and 28,000 of them are community residents here in our host city for this year's event in Birmingham. Well, so much in store this evening. The ceremony, of course, is a celebration and is hosted by West Midlands Combined Mayor's Authority and West Midlands Growth Company. And shortly, we're in for a real treat as well, as Step Change Dance Studios give us a vibrant Bollywood performance. And then the Lord Mayor of Birmingham, the Right Worshipful Councillor Charman Lal, will proudly welcome the athletes and audience here inside Symphony Hall to the city of Birmingham. Then all of the important parading of the flags will take place for all 60 participating nations. We've seen a few of them queuing up, ready to come in outside as well, from the likes of Japan, Puerto Rico, Sweden, Australia, Pakistan, I can see in their numbers in Symphony Hall away to the left-hand side, who'll be taking part in the cricket competition, to name one of the sports as well. Then we'll be seeing the fabulous Inner Vision Orchestra. They'll be playing throughout the evening. Several renditions of their performances we'll be seeing too. We'll hear from the International Blind Sports Association President, Ilgar Rahimov, before the athletes and officials take their oath as well before the audience. And then finally, the chair of the British Blind Sports Association, Sally Barker, MBE, will deliver a closing address as well. The orchestra are ready and prepared on the stage, which is lit up beautifully here at Symphony Hall. We've had dreadful weather in the city throughout the afternoon, throughout the day as well. But it brightened up a bit earlier on, and now we can welcome our compere onto the stage as well for tonight's proceedings. Master of Ceremonies, Mr. David Sharp.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome to the opening ceremony of the IBSA World Games 2023 here at the wonderful Symphony Hall in Birmingham. Give us a big round of applause. I'm Dave Sharp, and I'll be your host for what promises to be a fantastic occasion. And you can probably tell we're here to celebrate and enjoy ourselves. And so I encourage you to whoop and cheer and clap along and give encouragement to everyone. Can you do that for me? At the moment, these guys up here are leading the way in the cheering competition, closely followed by these guys on the front row. So, not... Here, Aussie, Aussie, Aussie! The Aussies are in. How are you? Staging an amazing World Cup over in Australia. That's fantastic, but I'm not going there. So, we're here for a really good time as we celebrate all of you being here from 70 nations across the world. And we've got a wonderful array of entertainment and presenters for you. And I hope that you will give them every encouragement through your whooping and cheering as the evening goes on. And of course, we'll have the flag-bearing ceremony and the official opening later on. But it's my great pleasure, as I walk over to my office for the evening, to introduce you to some friends of mine who are from this area. They're called Dance Dosti. They're from Step Change Dance Studios. I'll tell you a little bit about them later on. Give a big cheer as I read their names. The dancers are Claire, Esme, Hamza, Hardeep, Mariam, Mina, Mo, Poonam, and Sam. But first, we've got a duet, and they are Esme and Aparajita, and they've created a piece inspired by a classical Indian dance to the song Arja Nachale. Everyone, please give a big cheer and dance along if you want to Dance Dosti.
David Sharp there introducing the Step Change Dance Studios, who will now deliver a Bollywood performance. Dance Dosti there, part of the Step Change Dance Studios.
मुझे मेरा वाला डांस ये है ये है ये है ये है मेरा वाला डांस तो नाचो
Wow! How amazing are those guys? And what you probably don't know is that tonight was the first time they've ever performed that piece, especially for you, which they only rehearsed the last couple of weeks. Give them a big round of applause. All from Southeast Asia Heritage, all blind and partially sighted. Brilliant. So, we're on with the show. We're on with the opening ceremony. It's now my great pleasure, and will you please give a warm welcome to the Right Worshipful, the Lord Mayor of Birmingham, Councillor Chaman Lal.
Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, good evening. I'm incredibly pleased to welcome you to Birmingham for the 7th International Blind Sport Association World Games. Isn't it wonderful? It's Birmingham, the first city in the UK to hold the International Blind Sport World Games. Birmingham is proud of its sporting heritage. The city enjoys a global reputation as a leading venue for staging major sporting events, and we are delighted to be hosting another world-class games here in the city, Birmingham. Following our hugely successful Commonwealth Games last year, in a very short time, within a budget, we understand the significant role major events play in sustaining the visitor economy for Birmingham, and also how they can inspire our communities to participate in sport. I would like to extend a warm welcome to our visitors around the world. Please come again and again. There's so much in Birmingham to offer you. I hope you have an opportunity to experience all that Birmingham has to offer during your visit. Please take your time out from your games. Have a look around. There's something for everyone. I'd like to wish the best of luck to all the athletes competing in the games. Thank you very much.
Thank you to the Lord Mayor there of Birmingham. Are you having a good time in Birmingham, by the way? Have you had a chance to have a little look around? Yeah, you're getting a warm welcome? This is the city where I went to college, and this area that you're in now has all been developed over the last 20 or 30 years. So if you get a chance to have a good mooch around while you're here, you'd be most welcome. And of course, throughout Birmingham and the wider area. So if you get chance between sports, then you can do that. Now, as you can probably see, we are joined now on stage by the Inner Vision Orchestra. They're going to be with us all evening playing music for you, including an anthem which has been written especially for this evening, which we'll come to later on. Before that, we have the parade of flags. Now, this is the bit where I expect you to really, really cheer loudly, because when I announce your country, that's when you go crazy, okay, and give a big cheer. So there's quite a few to get through. You'll see them come on stage when I announce them. And when you see yours and everybody else's as well, because we're all in this together, give everybody a big cheer. So are you okay to do that for me? Thank you so much. Right, I'm going to go over here and get ready, and we'll start with our first one. And while you're there, the Inner Vision Orchestra will play along too.
Just waiting for the flag bearers to come on stage. As David Sharp, the Master of Ceremonies, mentioned just there, they are joined on stage by the Inner Vision Orchestra, who will be with us for an extended period now for several different performances. And they're now getting us underway. We're going to start seeing
everyone,
some of the
please welcome Algeria
making their way onto the stage, starting with Algeria.
Algeria have a delegation of six, and they will be taking part in the judo.
Six different delegates representing Algeria.
Next up, it's Argentina.
Huge cheer, bro.
Delegation of 50 taking part in judo. Men's blind football, women's blind football, men's goalball and tennis. Next, it's Australia. A delegation of 91 taking part in judo, men's cricket, women's goalball, men's goalball, tennis, powerlifting and archery. Please welcome next Austria. A delegation of 10 taking part in women's blind football and tennis. Please now welcome Azerbaijan. A delegation of 27 taking part in judo and chess. Next we have Bangladesh.
Bangladesh,
a delegation of 21 taking part in the men's cricket. Please welcome Belgium. their delegation of six, taking part in showdown and archery. Well, welcome to Brazil.
Brazil, of course, we know how impressive they are.
A delegation of 59 from Brazil taking part in judo, men's blind football, and women's goalball.
Judo.
Next, give a big cheer for Bulgaria. A delegation of 11 taking part in chess, showdown, and archery.
Their seat, it's Bulgaria.
Next up, it's Canada. Give a warm welcome to their delegation of 14 taking part in judo and women's volleyball.
Since the judo will be hotly contested, so many nations taking part in the judo.
Now we are China.
Now China, that's got the biggest cheer of the evening so far.
46. Taking part in judo, men's blind football, and women's goalball. Next, it's Chinese Taipei.
A delegation Chinese Taipei.
Of 11. Taking part in judo and tenpin bowling. Please now welcome Colombia.
Up next, Colombia. We saw the men's blind football Colombian side taking part against France a little earlier on. So strong, so impressive. We've already won, beaten Spain as well in that competition.
A delegation of four taking part in judo.
The Croatians now also taking part in judo.
We have Cuba. A delegation of seven taking part in judo.
Now it's Cuba's turn to take to the stage.
Now please welcome Chechia. A delegation of 24 taking part in chess, tenpin bowling, powerlifting and showdown.
Powerlifting for the Czech Republic.
Next up, it is Denmark. A delegation of six taking part in women's goalball.
Here come Denmark.
Please give a warm welcome to Egypt. A delegation of 28 taking part in judo, powerlifting, men's goalball and archery.
Up next, it's Egypt who will be taking part in the archery
next
contest.
Up,
a bit of a dance
Estonia
as well for the flag bearer for Egypt.
Delegation of five.
Now it's taking Estonia's turn to take to the stage.
Give it up for Finland.
Well, we saw the Finns arriving
delegation
outside in their droves and their in fine voice waving their flags around in the audience and auditorium as well.
And women's goalball. Next, please welcome France. A delegation of 52 taking
of
part
France.
In Parsons United football.
Mentioned them taking
men's
part in men's
blind
football a bit earlier on today. One all draw against Colombia. Put up a good fight, got an
please
equaliser late
Georgia
in the game.
A delegation of 21.
Now the Georgians arrive on stage.
Next, please welcome Germany. A delegation of 87 taking part in judo, showdown, men's blind football, women's blind football, men's goalball, women's goalball, archery and tennis.
Well, David Sharp mentioned the
next
women's blind football there. They played out a 0-0 draw this morning, Germany, but will take part in a bit of a playoff game tomorrow to decide who takes up those bottom places in their group in the women's blind football contest. Just as Greece take to the stage as well.
Taking part in the 10-pin bowling. Following them, welcome Hungary.
Now Hong Kong on stage. Now the stage is really awash with colour as all these fabulous nations bear their flags
Next to warm welcome
mentioned
to our friends
earlier
from
on
India.
In the broadcast as Hungary take to the stage. There's so much unity in between the countries as well. Everybody supporting each other. Competitiveness and competition, but in amongst it all, there's that real sense of excitement leading into all the competitions as India make their way across stage now.
Taking part in the judo.
Up next, it's Indonesia.
Please now welcome the Islamic Republic of Iran. 43 delegates taking part in judo, powerlifting, men's blind football and men's goalball. Next, a big cheer, please, for Ireland.
There go, Iran.
Delegation of 13 taking part in the tennis.
Big cheer for Ireland, of course. Haven't had to travel too far.
Next we have Israel.
They make their way up onto the stage. And now it's Israel that take their spot.
Taking part in women's goalball, 10-pin bowling. Next, please welcome
10-pin bowling, one
Italy.
Of the sports that Israel will be taking part in. And now a big cheer, a rousing cheer for the Italians.
Taking part in showdown, men's blind football,
all four corners of Symphony Hall.
Tennis and archery. Next, a cheer please for Japan. 122 delegates taking part in 10-pin bowling, powerlifting, judo, men's blind football, men's goalball, partially sighted football, women's goalball, women's blind football, and tennis.
I heard powerlifting in amongst all of that for Japan
Kazakhstan.
As they come on to the stage.
34 delegates taking part in judo and powerlifting.
Judo for Kazakhstan. They'll be looking to
now,
stake their claim for top spot in judo. And that is the biggest cheer of the evening as Korea come out all in unison. The athletes hop to their feet in the middle section of the auditorium and give their flag bearer the biggest cheer of the night so far.
Taking part in the judo.
On come Kyrgyzstan.
Next we have Latvia.
All of the flag bearers walk out to the beautiful sounds of the Inner Vision Orchestra, who are playing one of their magical songs on stage. Here come Latvia.
15 delegates taking part in.
And now Lithuania as well.
Judo and tennis. Next, we have Luxembourg. Two delegates.
Luxembourg now small in size, but I'm sure they'll be looking to stake their claim for top spots in the IBSA Games. Now it's Madagascar's turn to take to the stage.
Please welcome Mexico. 23 delegates taking part in judo, men's blind football and tennis.
Blind football for Mexico.
Next we have Moldova.
Now Moldova.
7 delegates taking part in the judo.
Or judo for Moldova. That's going
Please
to be quite the contest.
Morocco. 24 delegates.
Morocco now, who have been playing and taking part in the men's blind football earlier on today as well. Can catch
now,
up with the men's blind football
the
across the IBSA YouTube channel as well from all of the week. Of course, that contest started earlier than the rest of the competitions.
Everyone a big cheer now for Pakistan.
Here come the Netherlands and now Pakistan. And the Pakistani athletes are away to our left-hand side as we see it in the auditorium. And they all jump to their feet as well. They've got a big flag draped over the
Next we
the balcony as well, real noise for them. But all of these nations really supporting each other as Poland come out now.
In showdown, 10-pin bowling and tennis. Now please welcome Portugal.
One game in the men's blind football taking place now. Brazil 1-0 up against Morocco as well, so that's a live score. You can catch
Please
that if you want to switch
Puerto
between
Rico.
Both this ceremony and the men's blind football. You can do just that on the IBSA channel. Just missed Portugal there. They have made their way up onto the stage, and now it's Puerto
Next
Rico.
Up, Romania. 13 delegates taking part in judo, chess.
Chess for the Romanians.
Next, it's Singapore.
And now Singapore.
Two delegates taking part in tenpin bowling.
Tenpin bowling for Singapore.
Now please give a welcome to Slovakia. Seven delegates taking part in showdown.
Now it's Slovakia. Beautiful noise inside
now
Symphony Hall.
Welcome our friends
solo
from
singer
South
and a pianist
Africa.
Playing as it stands.
Three delegates taking part.
As South Africa make their way across stage.
Next up, a big cheer for Spain.
And now Spain, and that's probably given Korea a run for their money in terms of noise levels. The Spaniards are on their feet, competing in the blind football.
Please welcome Sweden.
And that's a big grin from the flag bearer up there. Sweden make their way out now.
A big cheer now, please, for Switzerland.
Here come the Swiss.
Six delegates taking part in the judo and showdown.
Six athletes taking part for Switzerland.
Next up, it's
Thailand. Guessed it, they're involved in the judo.
18 delegates.
Here come Thailand.
Now, please, a warm welcome from Turkey. 67 delegates taking part.
Here come Turkey.
Powerlifting.
Heavily involved in the blind football, Turkey. Up.
Next up, it's Uganda.
Up next, Uganda.
Three delegates taking part in the archery.
What a sight it's starting to be
now
up on that main stage
Ukraine.
For the parade of nations flags with the Inner Vision Orchestra and a huge cheer naturally for Ukraine.
Judo,
lots of the auditorium on their feet, including those Ukrainian athletes. And a big round of applause all the way around the Symphony Hall here as Uruguay make their way out onto the main stage. Getting towards the end now.
The USA.
The nations coming out and their flag bearers as the USA receive a warm applause. No doubt they'll be fighting on all fronts, the USA.
Uzbekistan. 32 delegates.
Penultimate flag to be brought out is Uzbekistan. But I have a feeling that the next nation to come out will get the biggest cheer of the lot.
Give a warm welcome to our host nation, Great Britain!
Here come Great Britain.
182 delegates taking part in judo, men's football, women's blind football, partially sighted football. Men's goal ball, women's goal ball, showdown, tennis, men's cricket, women's cricket, tenpin bowling, and archery.
And a big round of applause
everyone,
as well for the orchestra, the Inner Vision Orchestra.
The flags of our nations, please. And now, the world premiere performed by the Inner Vision Orchestra and written by Linda Shanson, the anthem for the games, You Can Make It If You Try. Please give a big round of applause.
Time for the anthem of the games now. You Can Make It If You Try.
Thank you. to your heart, listen to your heart, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Amazing was that. You can make it if you try. You certainly can. Well done. Top cheering as well and flag waving during the flag procession. Thank you for that. It's now my great pleasure, so please welcome to the stage the Cabinet Member for Health and Social Care here at Birmingham City Council. Will you please welcome Councillor Mariam Khan.
Ladies and gentlemen, and our distinguished guests. I'm very pleased and excited to welcome you to Birmingham for the first ever International Blind Sport Association World Games Birmingham 2023. Birmingham City Council is honoured to be one of the four key partners hosting this event for the very first time here in the UK. As stated by our Lord Mayor, last year Birmingham was centre stage as we hosted the Commonwealth Games, where 72 nations joined together to compete over 2 weeks across 19 different sports. And I know I'm biased, but I have to say it was the best Commonwealth Games ever, and you had to have been here to understand. We are utilising the infrastructure from last year and using many of the venues across the region that were used for Birmingham 2022, and further strengthened our relationship with the University of Birmingham to deliver major sporting events within the city. It's extremely important for us that athletes with sight loss have the same opportunities to compete at the highest level, providing a platform for people to recognise these athletes for their sporting skills. During these games, more than 1,000 athletes will compete across 10 different sports, including 3 Paralympic qualifiers. It's a chance to inspire our blind and partially sighted communities. These games won't just provide people the opportunity to lead more active lifestyles, but they can help build confidence, connect communities, and provide support networks. Our intention is to ensure that these games provide a sporting legacy for blind and partially sighted people in and beyond the West Midlands, creating an environment that is welcoming and accessible by enabling easier travel across the city and region for those with sight loss or other disabilities, and increasing the opportunity to access sports facilities and clubs, including goal ball and showdown. I hope that you enjoy tonight's ceremony, which will showcase the talent of local as well as international blind and partially sighted artists. And I have to say that the performances that we've already witnessed have been wonderful, so I'd like to say a thank you to all of the artists for an amazing start to the opening ceremony. And finally, best of luck to all of the athletes competing. And I couldn't miss this opportunity to say, especially Team Pakistan. Thank you.
Thank you to Councillor Mariam Khan there, and rallying the troops. And she's right, the Commonwealth Games were amazing. But I'm betting that you're going to have an even better time here. Now, we've got some more performers for you. As I mentioned, this is the Inner Vision Orchestra. And yes, a big round of applause. Inner Vision Orchestra, they're good, aren't they? They are good. And we're going to have a duet. We've got a soprano vocalist and a keyboard player. So please give a big round of applause for Victoria Orawari and Kevin Satazabal.
De mon amour, je vous...
Bravo! Kevin and Victoria will be back very shortly to play and sing for you again. How good does that sound in the Symphony Hall? That is amazing. Well done to you guys. We'll hear from them very shortly now. It is an absolute honour and privilege to tell you, and I'm excited also, that this evening we are joined by the President of the International Blind Sports Federation. Ladies, gentlemen, everyone, please give your warmest welcome to Ilgar Rahimov.
Thank you. Dear friends, athletes of our IBSA family, welcome to this our World Games here in Birmingham. The coming days are days for you to shine, days for you to show the world your potential, for each one of you to realize the results of all your preparation and sacrifices. These past 4 years have not been the best for you in terms of opportunities and events of performance because of the global pandemic. But here in Birmingham, I promise you, you will witness a new beginning for these World Games under the leadership of a new executive board determined to make this event for the future reach even more aspired visual impaired athletes around the world. In the coming days, you, our IBSA athletes, will take to the sports stage across the West Midlands. 1,200 opportunities for the world to amaze at your performance and to discover that sport for those with a visual impairment is indeed top sport. And remember that three Paralympic sports of goalball, football and judo are also qualification events for places at the Paris 2024 Paralympic Games. I am grateful to British Blind Sport, the local organizing committee and partners for all their efforts to deliver this event to such a high standard, given the personal, economic, world and domestic challenge that exists. Athletes, it's your time. Go from here and show the world that there are no barriers to high performance in sport, given the chance as the world will see here in Birmingham in the coming days. I wish you every success. Thank you.
Thank you to the President, Ilgar Rahimov. It's so good to have you here. Now, we've already heard from them once this evening. I'm sure you'd like to hear them again, wouldn't you? Give them a big cheer if you'd like to hear our singer and piano player again. Everyone, another duet with the wonderful Victoria Oruwari and Kevin Satisabal.
Me voglio far una casa mia somari. Me voglio far una casa mia somari. Fravicata di penne di pavoni, fravicata di penne di pavoni. Tra la la lira, tra la la lira, tra la 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 la. Tra la la lira, tra la la lira, tra la 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 la. coro d'argento gli scaline vari, d'oro e d'argento gli scaline vari, e le pronte preziose gli balconi, e le pronte preziose gli balconi. Quando nella mia ceva faccia ri, quando nella mia ceva faccia ri, ognuno dici, ognuno dici, lo spanta il sole.
Everyone, a big round of applause for Kevin and Victoria. Well done to them. Thanks also, and please give a big round of applause to the Inner Vision Orchestra. So hopefully, if you didn't enjoy it before, you're now converted to opera and classical music, just like me. So, we are coming to the close, almost. But before that, we need to say goodbye to our friends from the Inner Vision Orchestra. They have to leave, but I'm hoping I might be able to have a little chat with their founder, Baluji. So, as they walk out, just give them another round of applause. So, good night to our Inner Vision Orchestra. I'm hoping I can be joined by their founder, Baluji Shrivastav OBE. He's going to come and have a chat with me. Here he is. So these guys have got a little way to travel now, so they're going to leave. Yeah, another round of applause. Thank you so much. So I'm going to join Baluji on stage. This must be a great honor for you to be here this evening. It's not the first time you've done such a prestigious event, but you must be very happy.
Absolutely wonderful. Thank you very much for having Inner Vision Orchestra performing for you. That's wonderful.
Well, it's a pleasure to have you here. And of course, you were involved in the 2012 Paralympic Games as well.
Closing ceremony, and this is opening ceremony. So we are involved in both.
You've got a double whammy there. Yeah. And not only that, I mean, you are the sitar player to the stars. You've worked with some amazing artists, people that you will all have heard of. Just tell us a few people.
Should I drop them?
Yeah, you tell them. Go on.
Okay. Who is there?
Stevie Wonder,
Paul McCartney, Boy George, and Jazz Orient, which is Linda's group, my wife's group. And so lots of other, Future Sound of London. Yeah.
Brilliant. And you've done some recordings as well. I mean, you've worked with some of the world's best known and greatest artists, but you're a recording artist in your own right as well.
I have about 9 albums. So if you want to buy CDs, yeah, most welcome.
Yeah, that would be great. Yeah, we hope you get some sales as well from this. So, well, listen, we're very grateful that you joined us this evening.
We are very grateful too for having us here. Well, and hopefully we will be again here next game ceremony again.
Yeah, well, I know as well that you've celebrating 15 years of the Inner Vision Orchestra and the foundation and the work that you do. So you're on tour this year.
On tour, we have 17 concerts. And thank you very much for having us. And this is our 15th anniversary of Baluji Music Foundation. Brilliant. And Inner Vision Orchestra.
Brilliant. Thanks to you. I'm going to go back down to the lectern now. I'm going to leave you, Baluji. So kind of you to be here. Give it up again for Baluji. Okay, so now we have the athlete's oath. And to give the oath from England Blind Football, will you please welcome Ayman Hafiz, and from Great Britain Goalball, Dan Roper.
On behalf of all athletes at the 2023 International Blind Sports Federation World Games, we promise to respect and abide by the rules and principles of our federation and our sports. We will strive to give our best in the spirit of fair play, equality and inclusion, respecting the athletes, officials and participants in all situations and circumstances. Thank you.
Good evening. On behalf of all athletes at the 2023 International Blind Sports Federation World Games, we promise to respect and abide by the rules and principles of our federation and our sports. We will strive to do our best in the spirit of fair play, inclusivity, and equality, respecting all athletes, officials, and participants in all circumstances. Thank you very much and have a good games.
Thank you to Dan and Ayman. I was going to have a quick chat, but they've got training to do, being serious athletes. Now, the oaths aren't over yet. We need to listen to the joint head classifiers of the 2023 games to give the official oath on behalf of them. Will you please welcome Joy Mint and Claire Morton?
On behalf of all the officials at the 2023 International Blind Sports Federation World Games, we promise to officiate in these games with complete impartiality, respecting and abiding by the rules and principles of our federation and our sports.
We will strive to give our best in the spirit of fair play, inclusion and equality, respecting the athletes and officials in all circumstances.
Thank you.
Thank you both. And finally, before you leave, to declare the games officially open, please welcome the chair of British Blind Sport, Sally Barker, MBE.
Ladies and gentlemen and distinguished guests, as chair of British Blind Sport and the local organising committee for these games, I am honoured to be here to add my welcome to the 2023 IBSA World Games in Birmingham, England. For the first time ever, the IBSA World Games are being held in the UK, and we are delighted to have you all here. As the national governing body for the blind and partially sighted sport in the UK, British Blind Sport's role is to help and encourage adults and children to be active and play sport, whether it is at the grassroots level or the Paralympic Games. So we were very pleased when IBSA awarded us hosting of these games, as we knew that we could use the event to raise the profile of blind and partially sighted sport and to highlight the incredible skill and dedication of blind and partially sighted athletes to new audiences. The IBSA Games family for this event involves an incredible 2,500 people, whether they are athletes, coaches, officials, volunteers, or organisers, and that makes this the biggest IBSA World Games ever. Over 1,100 athletes representing 60 countries will participate in 11 sports, and they will play in around 1,000 games of incredibly skilled play. You, the athletes, represent the best of the best and serve as a source of inspiration for the next generation of sportsmen and women. We believe that this event will provide a great showcase for your talents as you compete against your peers from every corner of the globe. I encourage you to enjoy the journey and recognise and honour the years of hard work and determination that got you to this global stage representing your country. We are also joined here by a group of world-class coaches, officials, classifiers and volunteers without whom these games would not be possible. And I would like to thank you all in advance for your contribution to making these games a great success. To the many friends and family members who are here to cheer on these athletes, you also deserve significant credit. In many cases, these athletes wouldn't be here today without your selfless support. Thank you for being here during this, their important moment. Thank you also to the stakeholders and sponsors for making this moment happen. For the first time in history, these games will be broadcast or streamed worldwide. That is a huge step forward, and we expect that more people will watch these games than ever before. But the IBSA World Games are more than just a sporting event. They are a celebration of the power of sport to change lives and a powerful reminder that anything is possible if you set your mind to it. They are a celebration of the power of sport to unite people and break down barriers, and they are a chance for us all to show the world what blind and partially sighted people can achieve. So once again, welcome to all, and good luck to the competing athletes and teams. It is going to be a fantastic 10 days, and I hope you enjoy your time here in Birmingham, the UK's second city and one of the greenest cities in Europe. I now have great pleasure in declaring the 2023 IBSA World Games open. Thank you.
Thank you to Sally, you're absolutely right. Sport can be so powerful. So we are at the conclusion. I just want to say a few thank yous, and as I do so, I hope you'll give them a big cheer. When you came in this evening, you will have heard from DJ Hurricane. That's Parvez Hussain. Give him a big round of applause. Also, the Heavy Beats Brass Band. Step Change Dance Studio. That was Dance Dosti. Inner Vision Orchestra, who you heard from. Baluji Shrivastav OBE was here. Victoria and Kevin, of course. All of our VIPs, dignitaries, special guests and coaches. But most of all, a big round of applause and good luck to all of you, our athletes. Welcome to Birmingham. Enjoy the games. Have a great time. And I hope you have a brilliant, brilliant time. Take care. Have a safe onward journey. And I'll be watching with great interest to see who wins. Take care.